For this project, I'm going to use this yarn. This is orange color, and this is the yarn I'm going to use. Red Heart. This is the hook I'm going to use for this project. To begin this project, make a loop. Once we make loop, we are going to make 65 chains. Like this, make 65 chains. I made 65 chains, and this is how it looks. Now untwist your chains, just make them flat, untwist them and go to the beginning of the chain. So this is my beginning. This is the right side of the chain and this is the wrong side of the chain. So go to the wrong side and join the first end to the first beginning of the chain. This is my beginning of the chain. Before you join, make sure it's not twisted. See, now you can see the bumps on the back of the chains. Insert the hook in the bump and join the ends. To join the ends, make a slip stitch. To make a slip stitch, yarn over and bring the yarn through the loops. That completes the join. And make sure your yarn is not twisted, your loop is not twisted. By joining the round, our first round is completed. And now make 3 chains. 1, 2, 3. Then make a double crochet in the next chain. So this is my, after the join, this is my first bump. Yarn over. Insert the hook in the bump. Pull the yarn through the first bump. Now I got 3 loops on the hook. Bring the yarn through first 2 loops. Now I got 2 loops on the hook. Bring the yarn through the loops. That completes first double crochet. Make another one in the next chain. Yarn over. This is my next bump. again yarn over, go to the next bump. This is my third bump. Insert the hook in the bump. So this is my chain 3, acts as a double crochet. Then after that I made 3 more double crochets. This is how it looks so far, and keep doing until you reach the end. Keep making double crochet each and every chain until you reach the beginning of the round. I'm at the end of the round, and now I'm going to join this end with this beginning. This is my chain 3. 1, 2, 3. Insert the hook. Chain 3. Make a slip stitch. That joins the round. And this is how it looks for now. Once you join the round, the first round is completed, and we are going to move to the second round. The second round, make chain 1, and for each chain make a single crochet. To make a single crochet, insert the hook in the chain. See, grab the whole chain. This is my chain. Grab the whole chain. Yarn over, pull the yarn through the chain. Now I got 2 loops on the hook. Bring the thread through the loops. That makes a single crochet. And go to the next chain. So far I made 2 single crochets. Three single crochet. Four. So keep doing the same pattern until you reach at the end. I'm going to see at the end. I finished my second round. I made single crochet in each and every chain. So chain means this is what I'm talking. See, each and every chain. This is my end of the row, second row, and this is my beginning of the row. This is where I made the first chain before I made single crochet. This is my single chain, the beginning of the chain. So join the chain by making a slip stitch. Insert the hook in the chain. Make a slip stitch. That joins the round. So my second round is completed. And so I made double crochet and then in round 1. And a single crochet in round 2. So keep making round 1 and round 2 repeatedly until you get the desired length. But before that, I want you to try this band on your head. Pull through your head and check whether this band is enough for your neck. If it's not, it's always you can remove the stitches and make more stitches and do the same pattern. So it looks, this is how it looks so far. And keep doing round 1 and round 2 That means double crochet in round 1, double single crochet in round 2. I'll come back when I finish the pattern. This is how it looks. Now, so what I did, I made double crochet here, then I made single crochet second round, third round I made double crochet, and fourth round I tried little bit different stitch. So this is called half double crochet, and fifth round I made double crochet. I thought half double crochet looks prettier than single crochet, so I'm going to show you how to make half double crochet. But you can try any stitch you like to and try to experiment. This is my third row, this is my beginning of the row, this is my end of the stitch. I'm going to join 1, 2, 3 third chain, make a slip stitch to join the round. So I completed the round. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, I completed 5 rounds. This is my sixth round. I'm going to show you how to make half double crochet. So to begin the sixth round, make a single crochet, make a chain, then just like a double crochet, yarn over. Now I got one loop and yarn over, insert the hook in the next chain, pull the yarn. Now I got 3 loops on the hook. So instead of making double crochet, just pull the yarn through all loops. That makes a half double crochet. And again, yarn over, insert the hook, bring the yarn, 3 loops on the hook, bring the yarn through all loops. That makes half double crochet. So just like that, keep making until you reach the end. So you can, after this round, you can alternatively make double crochet in one round and half double crochet in another round, or you can change different other stitches if you want, and keep doing until you get the desired length. And once I finish my length, then I come back. Our cowl project, and I made, this is the whole pattern, this is how it comes. So the width of this, the width is 12 inches, and the length of this is 17 inches. So I keep on I was doing that 2 patterns repeatedly. This is double crochet and this is half double crochet. This is half double crochet. Double crochet, half, double crochet, DC, half DC, DC, half DC, DC, half DC, DC, half DC, like that. So this is how it looks. And I felt like a 17 inches is enough for me. If you need more height, then keep doing the pattern. And this is what this is my end of the round and this is my beginning of the round. Make a slip stitch to finish the round. Since I'm going to close my cowl, I'm going to make one more half double crochet round row. So I'm going to show you one more how to do that. One more time, chain one, yarn over, in the next chain insert the hook. I got three loops on the hook. Bring the thread from the loops, one, insert, yarn over, insert the hook, bring the thread, three loops on the hook, two, yarn over, three. So keep on doing the pattern. This is called half double crochet stitch. Once you finish, join the round. I'm going to come back. I'm at the end of the round. I'm going to join with a slip. This is my beginning of chain one. Join with a slip stitch. So here I made two half double crochets. Now I want to make a single crochet, chain one. To make a single crochet, insert the hook in the next chain. This is my next chain. Grab the thread, two chains on the hook, pull the thread from two chains. That makes a single crochet. Insert the hook in the next chain, two, three, four. So like that, keep doing. I'm going to make three rounds of single crochet. This is the first round. I'm going to make three rounds of single crochet and I come back. Just join each round with a slip stitch. I made four rows of single crochet here. See, 1, 2, 3, 4. Before that I made two rows of half double crochet. Then this is single double crochet row. And I'm going to finish it off. Then first I attach the needle to the thread. First insert the needle in the hole in the space, yarn over and pull the thread and make a knot. Once you make a knot, just hide the thread, insert the thread on each and every, see, on the chain. Just like that, just hide the thread in between those chains. And pull the thread, pull the needle. See, now it's very hard to see where the thread is. So the project is finished and I feel like the inside is much better. I'm going to in and out. And see, this is the pattern. The project is completed, and thank you very much for watching.